Children produce fewer and weaker antibodies, researchers say. Many cases of COVID-19 involve strong immune responses against the coronavirus. Some ended up with severe inflammation because their immune system overreacted to the infection. However, in children, the situation may appear differently. A new study suggests that children who contracted the virus may produce weaker antibodies compared to adults. Dr. Donna Farber, the study's lead author, said they may be infectious for a shorter time. According to the New York Times, children who produce fewer and weaker antibodies to COVID-19 are not automatically prone to reinfections. But it could give a clue on what science possibly overlooked in COVID-19 among younger people. The study, published in Nature Immunology, involved four groups of patients whose antibodies were analyzed. The first group had 19 adult convalescent plasma donors. The second group had 13 adults hospitalized due to acute respiratory distress syndrome linked to severe COVID-19. The third group had 16 children hospitalized with multisystem inflammatory syndrome, a rare complication in some children with COVID-19. The fourth group had 31 children with COVID-19 that did not develop the rare complication. Around 50% of children in the fourth group showed no symptoms. Results showed that all groups produced neutralizing antibodies for the coronavirus. This supported previous findings that most people infected with COVID-19 developed immune responses. The surprise was the difference in the antibody range between children and adults. Children's antibodies were mainly composed of one antibody type, immunoglobulin G or IgG. This antibody could recognize the spike protein of the coronavirus. Adults, on the other hand, had multiple antibody types that could detect several parts of the virus. Also, the antibodies from adults were more potent. Dr. Farber explained that the likely reason might be less severe infection among children than in adults. They identified that all children groups lacked the antibodies for a viral protein called the nucleocapsid, which is entangled with the viral genetic material. Being inside the coronavirus, the immune system would not create antibodies against it until the infection has spread widely. The insufficient antibodies for nucleocapsid may indicate the reduced infection course in most pediatric COVID-19 cases. But the findings may affect antibody tests that screen for the protein. Since children may not have the antibodies, these tests may fail to detect children who successfully cleared the virus. Experts caution people in interpreting the results. Right now, the findings are not absolute and may only clarify some details in pediatric COVID-19.